So your parents moved from Moscow to Texas?
Yeah, well, we actually moved when I was 2.5. We moved to New Orleans, the week of Mardi Gras.
Wow.
And my parents, like, couldn't speak any English.
Yeah.
Had no idea, like, where they were the week of Mardi Gras with, like, a 2.5-year-old baby. And they were like, what is this country?
Yeah.
And so that was kind of, like, the beginning of our journey. And we stay there for about a year, and then their dream and their goal was to always open up a gymnastics school. And so they had the opportunity to move to Dallas. Gymnastics was pretty big in Texas around that time, and so, and still is. But so, yeah, they were like, okay, well, let's, you know, go after that dream. And so they moved to Dallas.
Yeah. And so you were the experiment?
Yeah. Basically. You know, it's funny because they never even wanted me to do gymnastics. They were both gymnasts, and you know, my dad competed at the 88 Olympic Games, won 4 Olympic medals. My mom was a rhythmic gymnast and a world champion, and so as their only child, they were just like, we just want her to be happy. But for me, I truly found my happiness through gymnastics, and that was like my first passion, my first love, like literally everything about it. I just wanted to be in the gym. And so, you know, I think they said, especially early on, they're like, well, she also has this like strange God-given talent that like, you know, as you know, both of us were gymnasts, so like we can't really take that away from her, but we're never going to push her into doing gymnastics.
I've detected something. So the key is to tell you,
don't do it.
Don't worry about it. Yeah.
You're not moving to Boston. Don't worry about it. We're not moving to Boston.
That is so funny because I can feel like the traditional story with the athletes is like, you know, I don't know. I mean, obviously, there's so many examples.
Yeah.
Like Tiger Woods' dad, right? Like, there's so many. But it's usually like parents push them, and then the kid grows up and ends up hating it.
Oh, absolutely. I see that all the time because my parents own, you know, a gymnastics school, and the kids that, you know, burn out, it's most of the time it's because of the parents pushing them too much. And but yeah, I truly think that it has to be like your own dream and your goal, and not just for a sport when you're younger, but for anything in life. You know, I always tell kids, like, one day when you're gonna have a job, you know, like, you have to really love it, because you're gonna be spending a lot of time doing it. Like, I trained 7 hours a day, 6 days a week. And
oh, really?
So
there wasn't a book you just read that just said, like,
this is one reason why we wanted to have you, is because, like, so many things that we talk about, you know, David has done 5 companies, you know, and so we talk so much about, like, everybody wants this hack. They want, like, the shortcut.
The easy
right?
way out. Absolutely.
Yeah. And the only thing that, you know, people, the other thing we were talking about this morning, though, is the answers are always out there. Like, there's no secrets. Like, we can tell you, here's the things that we read or did this thing, or like, you know, the answer is hard work, or it's starting earlier, it's going 7 days a week. But nobody, even though people know the answer, it's the reason why there's a secret to getting a six pack and working.
Yeah,
it's working out, eating right. But
everybody
knows that.
They want to try the latest diets quickly get that six pack, and you know, it doesn't work that easily.
All right, so you know, I don't want to spend too much time like going back into the past. Mm-hmm. Like, you know, obviously, 5-time Olympic medalist, you won, you know, gold in 2008 all around. Where are those medals, by the way?
They're in Dallas at my parents' house. No, just in a safe. You know, it's funny because, like, my dad had 4 Olympic medals, too, and I never really saw them until the year of the Olympics. And it was kind of back at it, like, it was the best thing. I don't know if they did it intentionally, but growing up not seeing 4 Olympic medals in front of my face every single day, like, there was enough pressure, you know, that I put on myself to try to live up to my parents' expectations and try to live up to, like, what they achieved, because I just wanted to be like them. And so I think, like, not like if you walked into their house, like, you would never know that, like, we live there, because there's one picture from the Beijing Olympics in my dad's office, and that's it. Like, you would never know. And
man, your parents are smart.
Yeah. And, like, but I never really, like, thought about it. But I think the older I get, and now like thinking into the future, and like once we have kids too, like, same with our house. Like, our, you know, my fiance played hockey at BC, won 2 national titles, and our house has, like, nothing. You know, like, you would never know that we were even athletes. So I think
why did you say that?
Why are they smart? Yeah. Because they're doing the things that, you know, it's almost like the neg. They're doing the things, like, they're setting the right circumstances for you to grow up in and want those things.
Absolutely.
Right? They're not putting them in their face. Yeah. They're not, you know, there's this story of this entrepreneur that I listened to that talked about, like, he was telling a story about the Amish and saying, like, one of the things that they do there is, like, they reward the little kids with, the reward is doing the work. Mm-hmm. And so, like, you know, working in the fields. And if they do something bad, the punishment is you can't come to work today. right?
That's great.
So, I mean, that was like kind of, you know, if I got in trouble, like I couldn't go to gymnastics and it was like, oh my God, what? Like, you know, and that's like.
Because you love it. You didn't want to spite them.
Oh, like, yeah. Like if I got like a bad grade on a spelling test, my punishment was not going to training that day. And I like, so that's why I made sure to study that's really hard. Well, for multiple reasons, but you know, that was like a big.
I forget what. My wife and I were watching this video with Jerry Seinfeld, and he was talking about, he said, one morning, like, one of my kids comes up to me, and he's like, Daddy, are we rich? And he goes, well, I'm rich.
Yeah.
And that's, you're like, not. The mentality for the whole house. I think that's so good.